Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today is episode number 3 of hashtag YouTube Life. If you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Melissa and this is a new series on my channel. It's all about YouTube, growing your channel, gaining subscribers, just learning everything you need to learn about growing a successful YouTube channel. And if you want to really dive right in, I recommend you download my ebook. It's called The Ultimate YouTube Guide. I'm going to link it down below for you guys. I think if you're really serious about your channel and you really want to dive in right now, go check the ebook out. Again, I have it linked down below. Today's video is going to be all about the type of equipment and lighting and software you need to really start your channel. I want to start off by talking about different cameras that you could use to film your videos, because you are going to have quite a few options to get started. You don't have to dive right into the most expensive filming equipment, especially if you don't even know if you really want to do YouTube. I think in the beginning, it's really important to invest wisely and build your equipment up. All of the things that I have, I've acquired throughout the years. I've invested in everything myself. So don't feel like you need to have everything all at once. Get a few essential things as you go, and you can set goals for yourself and say, you know, by next year, I want to get this camera. In a couple years, I want to get this type of lighting equipment. You don't have to get everything right now. All right, so the first type of equipment that I think you should get is something to film yourself with. And before, I used to say, you know, you can't film on an iPhone. Like, you cannot use a phone to film your videos. But you know what? The iPhone cameras have gotten so great that I actually do recommend starting off on your phone, but not for every type of video. Like, if you are going to be doing really in-depth makeup tutorials, I don't think they're gonna look so great on iPhone quality. You can give it a try. But if you're gonna be vlogging and doing sit-down videos like this one, I think it is totally fine to start on your iPhone and just work with what you have and edit the videos from there. iPhone quality has definitely come a long, long way. The next camera I recommend, and I think if I was going to tell you to purchase a specific camera today, it would be this one. I'm actually filming with it right now, and it is the Sony A5100. I love this camera so much. I've been using it for years. And the reason I recommend this one specifically to start off with is because you're gonna be able to vlog with it, you're gonna be able to do makeup videos with it, and you're going to be able to take amazing photos. Like, this camera takes the most amazing, amazing photos. I love this camera so much. I think it is a great investment. If you're gonna be doing makeup videos with this camera, just know that it does burn out after about 15 minutes. You have to give it a break and then start filming again. So that's the only downfall, but besides that, it's a great camera. The next camera I recommend is the Canon 70D. That's another camera that I have, and I like to film with that camera mainly my makeup videos, because you can film for a really, really long time. I could film for like over an hour with that camera and it doesn't burn out. It is a DSLR and I use the stock lens that it comes with. It's another great camera. It autofocuses really, really fast, which is very helpful when you're filming videos. You do want to get a camera that will autofocus so you don't have to like mess with it too much and end up filming an out of focus video. But it is a really great DSLR camera to film with. And then a second DSLR camera that I do recommend, that I personally don't have, but I know a lot of huge YouTubers use this specific camera, especially for makeup videos, is the Canon Mark III. That camera is very, very pricey, so I don't think you need to dive in and get that camera first. I think you can set a goal for yourself and maybe get that one later on as you come along on your YouTube career. But it's definitely a camera that I want to invest in one day. It's super expensive, like I said, but I watch people's videos that film with that camera and it is spectacular. Also, keep in mind when it comes to DSLRs like the Canon 70D and the Canon Mark III, the video quality is going to vary depending on the lens that you use. With the DSLRs, I feel like you could drastically change the quality of your videos depending on the lens that you get. I don't have experience with other lenses. I usually just use the stock lens that it comes with and it works perfectly fine. But as you go along, you also want to look into different lenses that you want to change on your DSLR camera and do your research on them, because a lens can be pretty pricey. A lens can cost you more than the actual camera. Like, there are lenses that cost thousands of dollars. So that's something else that you can put as a goal and say, like, one day I want to invest in this lens for my makeup videos or for whatever type of videos you're filming. And then another camera that I really love that I use every single day is my Canon G7X. This is a smaller camera. I use this camera only for my vlogs. I don't like the photos, how they come out on here. I don't know if I have the settings wrong, but I don't really like the photos, but I love the quality of my vlogs with this camera. If you're gonna be vlogging, I think you would really like this camera because it makes the colors very vibrant and very bright, which is really important for vlogs, especially if you're vlogging like in dim lighting or it's not very bright in your home or wherever you're vlogging. This camera really brightens things up and makes everything look so much better. I would recommend this if you're like strictly gonna be doing vlogging. I think you would really like this one. All right, now shifting into lighting. Lighting is also really crucial when it comes to your videos because you might have a great camera, but if the lighting is off, your entire video will be off. The first type of lighting I recommend is to try to get your hands on a filming area where you have direct sunlight hitting you. I am filming right now in front of a window, which is really great because I have that natural lighting coming in. And I do also have a ring light in front of me because I need extra lighting. The natural lighting isn't quite enough, but it really does work a lot. So if you can film in front of a window, that is great because you can get away with filming like that for quite a while. And then if you cannot get some natural lighting into your filming space, then I recommend checking out some ring lights. I will link a few options for ring lights. I'll tell you guys the exact one that I use, which is the Diva Ring Light Nebula. I love it because it's LED, so it doesn't produce heat, which is very important for me because I used to have a regular ring light that would get so hot and I would be filming makeup videos and I would start sweating because I get hot very easily. But the Nebula version, the Nebula Ring Light, is LED, doesn't produce heat. I love it, but I know it's a bit pricey, so I will try to find some other ring lights that I think are really great as well, and I'll link them down below for you guys. So yeah, everything I've mentioned in the video, just make sure to check the description box because I'll link everything. You can also use umbrella lights. Umbrella lights are great because they're very bright, but they also are pretty affordable. I remember I bought a set of umbrella lights for like $50. So what I would do is I would have my ring light in front of me and I would have an umbrella light on each side of me. Right now, I'm only filming with the natural light and my ring light, but in the future, I am gonna be upgrading to the light that I'm about to tell you right now. Not everyone needs this. I feel like if you're doing like regular sit-down videos like this, or you're really vlogging and doing like lifestyle videos, you don't need crazy intense lighting. But if you want to focus on makeup videos, lighting is going to be really important for you. The next set of lights that I've been looking into that I don't have because it is very pricey, it's Kino Flow lights. They're very pricey, but they look amazing. So definitely in the future, I would love to get my hands on Kino Flow lights. I will link them below for you guys so you can check those out. But the first options that I gave you are really great to start your channel with. And then when it comes to actually editing your videos, I feel like most people use Apple, so I will tell you guys what you could use for Apple, but I know some people do have Windows. I don't have any experience editing on a Windows computer, but I will look up something that you guys could use. But for Apple users, use iMovie. iMovie is completely free. You can have it on your laptop or your desktop, and you can edit your videos from iMovie. If you want to learn how to edit, watch videos on YouTube. That is how I learned. I would look up iMovie tutorials, and when I would get stuck, I would just look up, how do I do this on iMovie? How do I do that on iMovie? And I would just watch a tutorial on it. The people that do the editing tutorials, they are really great at that. I don't think I would make a video on how I edit because I don't know how to explain the editing part, but I definitely recommend you just look up tutorials on YouTube. There are thousands of them, and you really learn how to edit as you go. Like, you're never gonna learn just by watching. You have to watch and apply it yourself, and you're gonna get better at it as you go. Trust me, when I started editing, I thought I was never gonna get it. It was like a foreign language to me. But if you're doing editing every single week, it's gonna start to come naturally to you. Right now, I edit with Final Cut Pro. Final Cut Pro is about $300. If you're not ready to purchase Final Cut Pro, I know they offer a 30-day trial of it, so you can try it out. When I first downloaded Final Cut Pro, it looks similar to iMovie, but there's so much more that you could do with Final Cut Pro. You can change the lighting on your video. So even though I'm filming right now with a ring light and I have decent lighting, when you watch my videos, the lighting has been further edited on Final Cut Pro. I always have to adjust like the lighting, make things brighter, saturate my skin a little bit, like just to really get it to look perfect. But yeah, with Final Cut Pro, you could do so much more. You could add a lot more elements and do special effects on your videos. So that's why I upgraded to Final Cut Pro, because I'm able to do a lot more of what I wanted to do for my videos. Now, when it comes to editing videos on a Windows computer, again, I don't have any experience with it. I've tried to look up editing softwares, but I'm not 100% sure like what's good. If you know any Windows type of editing softwares for videos, please leave it in the comments, share with everyone else. I think I saw one called Pinnacle. I don't know how good it is. So again, I just don't know, but just do your research and look up some video editing softwares for Windows and try to get some free ones so you can just start practicing and you don't have to spend money on a software if you don't have to quite yet. So this is going to be it for this video. If you miss anything, just check the description box. I will have links to everything that I have mentioned, all the cameras, the lighting, and the editing software as well. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Make sure you tune in next Tuesday for the next episode, and I will see you guys next time. Bye. Look at me.